the deal. Maybe you don't have unlimited funds to keep replacing poles. Seems like at least once a year, this year more than that. You end up knocking the end guide off of your pole, or maybe even breaking the end of the pole slightly, like in the rod box. So what you can do is basically just replace that. So here is camera, right? So here's a pole that I did, and what I've done is I've prepped the end by sanding this down so that there's no like broken or fractured pieces in the blank. And then I just sanded it a little bit to remove the finish. To me, that just helps the glue stick better. So we have a kit here that we bought that we will put the new tip from. Open that up. Now it has glue in it, and that glue works okay. It's kind of a heat applied glue, like a hot glue. Beat it with a lighter or some, or you can use a glue gun when you get home. Personally, I like a different glue if I got time, and I don't need the rod directly. E6000. To me, it's a fantastic glue. And you can see that tip here that I got. Get this rod over here. So this tip was the first one, which is 664ths. Super glue would work too if you have a good super glue brand. Thing to be careful about super glue is your working time, because sometimes that is a detriment to your job, because what happens is it glues fast, and then what happens is you can't position that tip correctly and you end up with something that looks like that. One of the things I like to do, and again, this is probably something you wouldn't do in the field, but normally, as you can see on these other guides, they put something over the top that actually holds the guides. Sometimes they use a thread to do it, and then use a like a urethane over the top of the thread to make that. And you know, it's all to not only make it smooth, but make it look nice. What I tend to do is basically, before I glue that on, take a piece of this shrink tubing here and then just slide it up over the rod. So, wait until that's glued on and then heat shrink that on. It gives it just a little nicer finish, and you know, it's smooth. Smoother, so line don't catch on it or whatever. So let me get find my E6000. I don't really care to use this glue, and I may be wrong on this. Since I don't have E6000, which is my preferred, I'm going to just go ahead and use some crazy glue on it. Position the rod tip where I want it then after sliding it on. So we've got that in there. Now it ain't going anywhere because that is dry. Some of the tea can wipe off the excess. Nope, ain't going nowhere, so it's gonna stay there. So, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna slide this heat shrink tubing up there. Now from a distance, I'm going to apply some heat to this little micro torch. And you want to be careful, almost better to use a heat gun in a low setting. If you use a micro torch, keep it away far enough that you don't damage the tip or damage the rod. Again, just enough heat to shrink that on there. And then there's our finished tip on your pole. This one's ready to go. Ready to use again. So instead of throwing it away, buying a new pole, you got some limited resources. Putting a new tip on a rod is real.